Well, charcuterie boards are all the rage right now, but no one does them quite like Katie Hogan. She creates custom-themed charcuterie boards, and she's here to give us some ideas for our Easter brunch. So welcome.
Thank you.
Kenny discovered her, and as always, we steal all of Kenny's cool people. So it's really cool because this started how long ago for you? She was an event coordinator.
I was an event coordinator and
babies came along.
Babies came along, so that didn't work for a work-life balance.
Right.
So I started this to kind of use my creativity as my creative outlet.
She's got some creativity. And her business grew like 300%. Like, it went crazy. She's all over social media. And it's fun because Stephanie and I love these charcuterie boards. We're obsessed. I had one for my one-year-old's birthday party, but my niece put it together because it kind of intimidates me.
It is.
I don't know where to put stuff. So, like, where do you begin? Like, can you give a couple tips?
Sure, of course. So a couple of the key things to remember is to add a lot of texture, color, height.
Yes.
You want it to be visually appealing. So,
okay.
For example, this is my crudité, my veggie board. With a spinach dip, and I love how colorful it is. I add a lot of beautiful different veggies that you normally
point out the specific ones. Like, is this what?
Sure.
This is actually a cheese that you just used a cookie cutter?
Yes.
Like, who does that? Katie does. Yeah.
I used a cookie cutter, a little bunny cookie cutter. We have Caprese skewers in there with tomato, basil, mozzarella. This is actually radish, and I made it into a rose.
How do you do that?
You use a mandolin and cut them very thin and roll them.
That's amazing.
It's not easy. It's time-consuming, but
yeah, that's why you order from Katie. Nobody does it themselves. Okay, and it's like bottomless though. Like, your charcuterie boards keep going.
They keep going.
Yeah,
you keep diving. The next thing you pick up, there's going to be something else underneath. So that's what I love. I love food. So
yes.
This is.
Oh, Katie, we're going to get along really well.
This is my calling.
Yes.
Another item that I offer are breakfast boxes.
Oh, fun.
So I do offer this for Easter as well. Last year I had a lot of moms reach out and say, while I'm cooking, I need something for my kids.
I'll lift it up for the camera.
Sure.
Talk about some of the specific stuff you have in here.
So I have hard-boiled eggs, sweets, chocolate-covered strawberries that are carrots, yogurts, nuts,
cookies.
And assorted fruit in there.
Oh.
That's okay.
And I'll eat it, don't worry.
Our famous little maple bacon roses.
Oh my gosh, how fun. The cookies are darling.
Yes,
the
cookies are from the Painter's Dozen. I incorporate a lot of small local businesses into my boards.
Yeah. What a great little brunch idea for Easter.
Yeah.
You know, nobody's got time to cook because we got to put ourselves together for those photos.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
So okay, so what'd you bring here?
Okay, well, we have a couple different cheeses that I'm going to work with, and I thought I'd share a couple tricks and tips.
Yes, we love tricks and tips.
This is a little crinkle cutter that we will just make cubes, and this is going to add a lot of texture to your board.
And that's the thing too, everything's got different texture. You got so many like flour, like you made meat, like a flour out of meat,
that's
out of salami.
The salami rose.
Yeah.
So I add a lot of, I offer charcuterie workshops. So that is one thing that a lot of people come in and they ask for. They want to know how to make that salami rose.
Okay.
So, a little quickly, I went around the rim of a champagne flute. And I'm going to finish it up here, the last few pieces. And the key is to pinch it all the way around.
Ooh.
And flip it over, and you have a beautiful little
rose. That's how you do it?
Yes.
You shouldn't have given away your secret.
I know.
I'm kidding. That is amazing.
I love to share. Yes. So even just adding a small little rose will visually make your board appealing.
Is this Brie?
Yes. Are you a fan of Brie?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm a fan of anything you brought today.
A lot of people don't like, I mean, I've had some people tell me they don't like Brie.
Oh, well.
So, my little secret is to go ahead and use a cheese wire.
Okay.
And you want to make sure your Brie is a little firmer than usual. So you want to pop it in the freezer.
Okay. They're showing video of all your...
Oh, good.
Awesome. And we're back. Okay. So, this is like the Oreo cookie yesterday.
Yeah. And hopefully this will work.
That's okay. So when you do that, then you just cut up the pieces and put them on the board?
So you would take the top rind off and then use a cookie cutter. I have a cute little bunny cookie cutter for the holidays.
Oh my goodness.
You will cut out that bunny.
How cute.
And then spread some jam on the
inner. I did notice you have a lot of little jams on here. It's like something you get like at the hotel or on the airplane or something. And I picked this up and there's three more layers.
Bottomless.
Very cute. Now, here's my question. You can mix the fruit with everything else. Like, it's not going to run together?
Right. No. So typically I put a lot more fruit than veggies. I'm more of a sweets girl.
Okay.
So there's a lot more candies and chocolates.
Gotcha.
With my boards.
Okay. Can we show them?
Yes.
Look. Here,
so,
John.
It's not lined up correctly, but you have a cute little bunny cut out with your jam in the middle.
Okay. So tell us where you're at on social media. We'll put it on fox8.com, but.
Yeah. So I'm on Facebook and Instagram.
Yes.
I have my own website going at blueandbrieco.com. You can send me messages directly to order boards.
Yeah, like if you want different ideas, like a theme.
Yes.
She does themes, like graduation parties or weddings or a birthday party.
From boards to grazing tables and luxury picnics.
Oh, it's so good. I said I could eat a charcuterie tray for like every meal for the rest of my life.
Yeah, they're delicious.
Yeah.
And so much variety.
Yeah, so much variety. We're going to link all of her stuff to fox8.com. This is such a great idea. Don't do it. Let her do it. Thanks, Katie. So
Thank
nice
you.
To meet you.
Nice
you did a great job.
You.